Now it's the moment to talk a bit about implementation and how to implement power electronic controls on an embedded platform. I go back to the Simulink, and I will show you this model that I called application software. In this model, I created my software architecture, so to speak, which I have using model reference. I'm calling other model that implements certain algorithms, for instance, some limits to my current. Supervisory logic that we saw partially with the operating mode management in stateflow, the closed loop control voltage, and the closed loop LED controllers. You can see different colors here. The colors are associated with a specific timing step so that we can already at a glance see which subsystem and different model are working at which rate and how they interact with one another. I can then go to the Apps tab, open up the Embedded Coder app. And if I don't know exactly how to start or which one is going to be my hardware platform, I can quickly start the quick start from the Embedded Coder. It's going to analyze the system. You can specify which kind of code you want to generate, C, C, AutoSAR, C++, C++, AutoSAR, how many instances. So you want to use one or it's going to be some reuse. So going to analyze the model. See how many sample rates are in our system, if there are any continuous states that can be implemented. And in the end, it's going to ask me if I want this to be a multitasking rate monotonic system, or if I have a single tasking with the fastest execution time, what I want to prioritize, execution or RAM. And in the end, it's going to suggest me some new value for my parameter on the code generation. You can see here already we have 22 parameters. In reality, there are hundreds of them that you can parameterize in order to get exactly the code that you wish. And for the embedded coder, it's very much suggested to take one of our training. Now, one new thing that we implemented is the ability to look at coded model by side by side with the code interface. Here, I can select my code interface, and then the code will pop up here on the side and allow me bidirectional traceability between the model and the code. If I go back to my closed loop control system, and if I instance pick this switch, the code here will automatically go to the C code generated for this subsystem. And I will see the switch actually, how this is going to be implemented. This one is implemented, where I can find the single part of my code that I may be more interested. It's a great way to learn how the embedded code generation works and to quickly see how my parameter configuration is going to affect the generated code. If I'm working with a development board, such as the one that I have in for Texas Instruments C2000, I could actually go to the add-on tab, search for the type of hardware. For instance, here I could search for C2000 and download specific hardware support package for embedded coder. There are for C2000, but there are for a lot of other platforms such as STMI and ARM processor, Raspberry, whatever you like. So really there is a lot of hardware supported, and this gives you driver blocks together with the ability to generate the executable and flash it directly on my embedded hardware. So, thanks to automatic code generation, we can deploy to any processor with best-in-class performance. Models can be generate structured text for PLC or industrial computer, can generate HDL code for FPGA, can generate CUDA code for GPUs or embedded GPUs, can as well generate C code or C++ for embedded processor or computer processor such as Intel or AMD. This technology not only allows you to connect to hardware by flashing specific boards such as the one from TI with the other support package, but MATLAB and Simulink overall, they work very well with hardware together. You can directly connect to oscilloscope, You can connect data acquisition devices, and you can connect your Simulink model with digital networks, as the one from OPC and CAN. You have dedicated toolbox for a lot of this hardware. So if hardware is important to you, please take a look at all the different hardware that we support to make your life easier in your lab. Another thing is that when you start generating code, your project is getting into production, and then you will need professional capability to manage your file and your model. For this, we have a Simulink project, which allows you to connect all your files together in a single entity with checks, such as Simulink project upgrade, that will help you keeping always up to date with the latest release. Simulink project is a feature from basic MATLAB, doesn't need any other toolbox. And again, within Simulink project, you can integrate version control, and then you can easily access Simulink graphical model comparison and merge. This has been included with Simulink, doesn't require an extra toolbox since 2017b. Before that, you would need the Simulink report generator, but we decided to take a step back and put it into the Simulink product by itself. So if you still don't have 17b, this could be a good reason. You don't need any additional toolbox. You can simply use Simulink project and get started with your analysis of your different version of your system. When we got to verification, we provide a lot of different things that you can do with automatic code generation. One of these is software in the loop, where you generate code of your algorithm and you embed it in the closed loop simulation. So okay, you can test if the generated code is functionally equivalent to the model. You could do processor in the loop or FPGA in the loop, in which the algorithm is going to be flashed on supported boards, and then through connection, the processor will work one time step, will feed back the result to the simulation, and will do this non-real-time functional verification, and will do performance profiling as well, so that you can actually accurately assess how performant is your algorithm and how many resources you have available. Third is hardware in the loop, where you have your algorithm working on your processor and your plant model generating code from SimScape Electrical. It's still possible to generate code from SimScape as well and put it on a real-time machine, for instance, the one from SpeedCode. I actually asked my partner at SpeedCode, Carlos Villegas, and he provided me with this few slides and the example of hardware in the loop for this SEPIC example. So SpeedCode is an associated company by Matrix in Switzerland that provide real-time solution for hardware in the loop and rapid code prototyping. And here we can see what they did with this model that I provided them. They used the SimScape to HDL technology to linearize the SEPIC at different operating point and then be able to flash it on a FPGA. So there is a workflow that we offer that allows you to go from a SimScape model to HDL code. And then this HDL code running on the FPGA allows us to test our algorithm that still has 100 kilohertz PVM signal, which is very fast. So we needed to have a very high resolution capture at 200 megahertz, and then to have the model running at least at 2 megahertz on our FPGA, something that they could achieve. And we can see here an example that they share with me, in which they deployed first the model to the embedded target, such as TI, and then deployed the bitstream on the SpeedCode machine. Finally, you can see on the right their oscilloscope, which is recording the different voltages. They are now going to increase the voltage. And we can see that the voltage reference is 9.18 voltage, and the voltage output is going to change to 18 voltage. And you can see the different voltages of the condensate capacitor or at the PVM signal, all capture working at 100 kilohertz in hardware in the loop. So that's another very interesting work in which you can reuse some of the model that you did, translate them to HDL, and provide so closed loop capabilities for high frequency switching system. You can see here now in the data inspector how the system behaves almost exactly like I had in my simulation. This closes our session. Again, let me showcase what we walked through this today. We modeled the SEPIC based on the hardware module from Texas Instrument. We programmed and tuned control logic and supervisory logic. We then generated C code and used the other support packages to bring it onto this hardware, like we can see right now. In this case, we could control the LED current to 60 mA using parameters that we derived thanks to our control design tuning capabilities combined with system identification, so that we could use a high fidelity model with switched linear component in order to get the optimal parameter for my control design. An example of a customer using this workflow, ABB, very well known for the power conversion community. And what Dr. Robert Turner from ABB New Zealand said is that simulation and code generation enabled us to turn changes around quickly and eliminate human error in coding, and their developer productivity is easily increased tenfold. This is a strong statement by one of the leading power electronic company in the world. Let me conclude by repeating the three key takeaways. We have graphical programming, stateful simulink across our solution, which are very intuitive and powerful. State-of-the-art technology, such as solver and control design technique, facilitate the design and verification of this complex system developed by your team, which is by nature multidisciplinary. This will allow you to find design error early and cut down development cost while increasing quality. I'd like to do a shout out to our power electronics control community on MATLAB Center. You have their models, answer, how-to videos, and the ability to interact with other power electronics experts from MathWorks and from the industry. Thank you very much for your participation, and stay safe till the next time.